What's going on, guys? We got a Polaris 570 in the shop today. This is a Ranger, and customers having trouble with it keeping the battery charged and everything. So we're gonna go through the steps on what you gotta do to go through and replace the stator on it. So let's get started. So first thing we're gonna do before we get started on this is take our wheel off to get it out of our way. So the first thing we're gonna do here is remove this hose clamp so we can remove this hose. And yes, we're gonna lose some water and stuff. We got a drain pan down here to catch most of it. And then we're gonna work on taking this loose, this cover off, so we can gain access to everything behind it. Now that we got our hose here loose, we're going to take our crank sensor off so we can take our bolts out and pull this cover off. Alright, so we got all our bolts out. You want to go through and double check to make sure you got them all out. Before you pull this side cover, you want to remove your dipstick and make sure you have an oil pan to catch all your oil so you don't make a mess. Once you get your side cover off, as you can see, you're going to want to remove your stator. You got three bolts here that hold your stator in. This does go in a certain way. And then you got two bolts over here that holds this little wire guard down. And you got this little rubber grommet that holds your wires in. So right now we're gonna work on getting these three bolts out as well as these two. I've done got this in loose. So we're gonna get these other two out and remove these two. So when I said this goes on a certain way, you got your wires here coming off of your coils. Them go facing down, and you want to position it into a way to where whenever you get your rubber grommet and everything, that it all feeds up through here a certain way. Once you got your holes lined up and everything seated in there like it's supposed to be and your wires seated down in there and there ain't a lot of slack or nothing built up, everything's tucked in so when your flywheel goes on here, you ain't got to worry about it hitting anything. Then you can reinstall your bolts and then reinstall your guard on your wires right here. All right, guys, we got this installed. Now it's time just to clean this off and everything, get it ready to go back onto our machine. Don't forget that our parts and stuff that we used on this will be listed down in our description. So now let's get ready to install this back onto our machine. So what we're gonna do is wipe this off. Before we do that, we're gonna take this cover off here. This here is your water pump. And as you can see, it is slotted. And it's slotted for this to go in on the motor side. We'll show y'all that before we put this on. But this has got to line up perfectly. And to make sure it lines up right, we're going to take this cover off so we can make sure that we get it lined up correctly. Right here is your impeller that works your water pump. Now that we have this off and we got our other side wiped down, let's reinstall it back on our engine. Right here you can see our slot in between our flywheel that lines up with our slot here. So whenever you're putting this on, of course this is going to suck to it pretty quick because this has got a magnet on it. You do not want to beat this with a hammer. You want to just kind of work it. Till you get it lined up. Now as you can see right there, it is lined up in the slot. And it's down on our case flush. Now we're going to get ready to put our outer bolts in. We want to do them in a crisscross pattern to make sure this goes down flush. Just in case anybody is wondering, the torque spec on these is 6 to 7 foot-pounds. So now we're going to put our crank sensor back in. Make sure you got it pushed all the way down in, because it's got a rubber seal around it. You don't want to try to tighten it down without it being flush or else you take a risk of popping this ear off. And then reinstall your bolt and tighten it down. Now we're ready to put our cover back over our water pump, and just like the other seal, you want to check it to make sure it looks good, and this one does. And these bolts here on this water pump are the same torque specs as these. And you want to do these the same way, just do these in a crisscross pattern as well. Next step, we're going to put our hose clamp and hose on and tighten it down. Now you're ready to install your dipstick. And then what we're going to do now is plug up our stator. And we're going to have to let the machine down so we can get to our plug. But this job is finished here, all but plugging up our stator. And like I said, we're going to have to let our machine down, put our tire on and everything. But this right here wraps up this job. Don't forget, if you're looking for parts and stuff to complete a job like this, like we've done on this machine, it'll be down in the description along with any of our other videos on YouTube. All the parts and stuff we use is down in the description. And if you like videos like this to help keep your machines up and on the trail, don't forget to give us a subscribe and everything. Check us out on other social media platforms. And as always, we appreciate you guys following along. We'll catch you in the next video. When you guys get this thing set back down, don't forget to top your water off and stuff and burp the system. And check your oil and everything and make sure everything's where it's supposed to be. We'll catch you guys later.